Hey everyone, this is Dr. Maples. Today we're going to begin developing research questions. This is a fun process because it gives us a chance to reflect on the things that we love and cherish about sociology as a field, and also ask the questions that we have about society. We'll do a couple of things in this lecture series. We're going to spend some time reflecting on the things that you like about sociology, and then turn those into some basic questions that we could explore in a study that would be sociological in nature. We'll also spend some time thinking about improving our questions and making sure, too, that they don't include things like bias that could give us bad results. So excited to get started on this. So first things first, understand that all great research begins with questions. Well, maybe. All great research begins with ideas, and we turn those ideas into questions. So let's think about that. Now, when we start with a research question, we're really reflecting on the things that we as students of sociology love about this field. Sometimes it's our curiosities about how society works, about our experiences as an individual living in this society, and how society can shape those experiences. You may not have realized it too, but you've been developing your own research questions along the way. For example, sometimes you choose certain courses over others. Why? Well, maybe it's you liked the professor, but it also could be that you liked the topic. Likewise, when you write papers or you choose certain things to read, you often think about things that you would identify as your favorite sociological topics. So what we want to do today is start to pull a few of those ideas out. So what we're going to do is try to think about the things that interest you in sociology and turn them from ideas into basic questions. We won't even say sociological questions yet. We're just going to say questions. So I want to go back in time, many years, to when I was an undergraduate. And when I was an undergraduate student in sociology, particularly my junior and my senior year, I really had some very clear interests in terms of the things that interested me in a sociology and as a sociology student. I was really interested in social organization and social control. I had taken a course on human revolutions and, or social revolutions rather. And that course really piqued my interest in both how we as individuals are capable of changing society, but also how society can reinforce norms on individuals. In fact, I started noticing recently, as I thought about the different classes that I took after that, I took the required classes in the major, yeah, but the courses that I picked out when I could really clearly reflected on this idea of social organization and control with an interest in the field of political economy, which relates to that idea of control. It's basically the linking point of sociology, political sciences, and economics. And I was just really interested in that. Likewise, too, I was interested in periods of unrest, kind of like we live in now, and how those shape the individual's experience. Now, posed to ask research questions, or requested to ask research questions back then, I probably couldn't have framed them. That would have been a helpful thing to think about, though. So that's what I want to do with you. I've shared some basic things that interest me. What I'd like you to do is start thinking about these ideas and how you think about sociology and what interests you, and maybe think about those big ideas and practice turning them into questions. Now, I'm going to share some really clear versions of the things that interest me as a sociologist today. What I'm going to want you to do is go to Blackboard and check in on our discussion board. And there you're going to see an opportunity for you to share this information with the class. This is not for a grade. This is a chance for you to share these ideas with others, see what interests them, maybe make some research connections with other people who might share some interests of yours, but also to see what other people are thinking about. So that's what we're going to work on. Start first by thinking through the things in sociology, the classes you've taken, the books you've read, the professors you've worked with. Think about the things that stuck with you. Think about the ideas that if you had to talk about sociology as a field now, what are the go-to things that you might talk about? Think about, are there particular ideas or topics that really interested you? I'd want you to go ahead and make a list of those right now. In fact, feel free to pause the video while you do that. Make a nice list of anything that's sociological that you can think of that interests you. Now, as you look at these, think about them in terms of really big ideas, but also think about ways to make them into smaller ideas. Like maybe you say, well, I'm interested in poverty. That's a great topic. What specific elements of poverty? Could it be rural poverty that interests you? Could it be poverty in the household that interests you? Could it be poverty and wages that interest you? So if you get really big ideas like that, try to break them down. Same thing if your interests are like health disparity. What specifically about health disparity? Is it quality of life care? Is it access to medical insurance? Is it regional differences in health disparities? And so forth. Now, you can also think about the specific classes that you've taken. Maybe you had a class that was just your all-time favorite. That could also be something that you would say is an interest of yours. Look on Blackboard, look in the discussion section, and start sharing these. Likewise, what I want you to do is turn these into statements of things that you're interested in, but also I want you to take a moment, as I will, and try to turn these into research questions. Now, fair warning, the first time you try to do this, it doesn't always go really well, and that's okay. That's actually very normal. This is something that we intentionally have to think about. In fact, I kind of want to go sociologist on you for just a moment, if you don't mind. We've been socialized to not ask questions. We've been socialized to just sort of follow what we're supposed to do and adhere to those ideas and not ask questions. Moreover, you maybe haven't been trained to think like a researcher. Well, now we get to start undoing some of that sociology and socialization, more importantly, and get you thinking in that process, get you thinking along those lines. All right, so that's what I want you to work on with the discussion section. I'm sorry, the discussion board, but I want you to look at my examples first, okay? Now, if I just had to frame in a sentence, as you will, three things, and I had to narrow it down to these three, that interest me as a sociologist, these are the three things that I would probably say in an order. First off, I'm interested in outdoor recreation users, and I'm really interested in what they do in rural economies. I like to talk about Kentucky's Red River Gorge quite a bit. That's an area I've written a book on. That's an area where I've conducted several studies. And it's somewhere that's near and dear to me. But I like to think of what outdoor recreation users are doing for the economies in those areas. That's one. We'll come back to that in the form of a question in a moment, but that's one. The next one is I'm interested in rural residents and how we keep them engaged in things that are happening in their communities and economies and so forth, politics too. In fact, this goes back to that course that I took on social revolutions back in college. I'm interested in how we keep a person who lives in a place like Powell County actively involved in the decision-making process, because what often happens in these areas is they get lost in the system and their interests aren't checked and they're not asked for opinions. They're just sort of told, well, this is what we're going to do. My third one is kind of a new one, but it's bumped its way up the ladder. I'm really interested in telecommuting, thinking about writing a book about it. Telecommuting is where you're able to work from home because your profession allows you to be mobile. Telecommuting, I'm particularly interested in this idea amongst outdoor recreation users because I find a lot of them are changing jobs or going into fields that they basically can work from anywhere. As long as they have some kind of internet connection and the ability to move data from a computer to some other computer somewhere else, they're able to work. And that's exciting because that could have some really cool implications for places like the Red River Gorge. It could change everything from its economy, its tax dollars, to even the makeup of its population. Likewise, this is an area where a lot of people are leaving. Telecommuting actually seems to be reversing that trend just a bit. Those are three ideas. Now notice these aren't questions. These are sentences. These are statements. I'm interested in blah, whatever blah would be. So what I want to try to do is turn those into questions. In fact, I'm going to ask you to do that in the discussion board assignment as well. You're going to try and take your ideas that you've stated and turn them into questions. Now, if I had to turn these into questions, what might I do? Well, for me, if I wanted to take that first idea and turn it into a question, I could ask something like, how might outdoor recreation users impact transitional economies in rural areas? And what are the social barriers to making that happen? Now, I just threw some sociology words at you. Let me explain those. A transitional economy is an economy that's moving from one particular kind of economic activity to either an unknown new one or some other field. We're actually a really good example of transitional economies in eastern Kentucky because we have a lot of counties that depended on coal mining for many years. And now, because the coal markets have changed, that's going away. Whether we like it or not, that's just kind of the scenario that we're experiencing. If you're interested in more about that, you can take some of Dr. Pellucci's courses, by the way, on world systems analysis. Anyways, with these transitional economies, I'm interested in what outdoor recreation might do for those. To see maybe how it might be a useful source of economic activity. It's probably not enough to hold the whole economy up, but it could give something to hold us off while we're figuring out what comes next, like maybe a new form of manufacturing. That's one way where I've turned in my first idea into now a question. Second, what if we asked about keeping community members engaged? What if we asked something like, what are some of the social barriers to rural residents being included in planned social changes in their communities? And how, as applied sociologists like me, can we work with communities to make that happen? So we've turned a simple idea of being interested in how community members are engaged in their communities and asking that in a very sociological way. In fact, we're even thinking about the way that our research could now benefit them. Yeah, that's good. It's applied sociology. That third one we asked about had the idea of telecommuting. So maybe if we took our idea of telecommuting and outdoor recreation users, we could ask something like, given the rapid increase of telecommunication jobs, how might telecommuting career opportunities function in rural economies, particularly those visited by outdoor recreation users? For example, maybe they're bringing in new jobs with them, these outdoor recreation users, that could help other people. So now we got a book topic there. That's a great sociological question. These are all examples of me, a PhD sociologist, taking ideas and turning them into questions. I promise yours will not go as smoothly, and that's okay. But what I do want you to do is take some time to write down the things that interest you in sociology. Take some of those ideas and turn three of them into ideas that you are really interested in studying. And then try turning those into questions. Don't feel stressed. Don't feel concerned if they're not good enough, because they will be. We're simply trying to start that process of thinking about it. All right, that's going to wrap up this part of the lecture. In the next one, we're going to start thinking about taking these questions a step bigger, from being just questions to being sociological questions, which is an exciting, sometimes intimidating journey. I look forward to seeing you there. If you got any questions about that discussion board assignment, you let me know. Talk soon. See ya.